When we talk about our diet, we mostly refer to carbohydrates, fat and proteins, mm-hmm. which are so-called macronutrients.
Right.
However, our food also contains another very important factor, and that's micronutrients, mm-hmm. such as vitamins, which are even more important for your baby. That's because they promote your baby's growth and development, and they also help reduce the risk of complications such as birth defects.
Yes. So in this video, we are first going to walk you through 6 micronutrients that your baby urgently needs when you're pregnant. And we're also going to tell you which foods contain these nutrients. And then we're going to share with you 3 additional micronutrients, which are even more important for your baby, but which are very difficult to get through your diet alone.
Yes, this is Nathalie, a pregnancy and birth consultant and TCM therapist.
And that's Mathias, a researcher and science geek.
And we are here to help you and your baby naturally and science-based. So let's talk about micronutrients. There is a very popular saying which says, eat for two when you're pregnant. However, gaining that much weight is just not necessary for a healthy pregnancy. In fact, it can even be risky for both you and your baby, as many scientific studies have shown. Instead, the American College of Obstetricians and Gynecologists recommends an extra 340 calories per day in addition to your normal diet, starting in the second trimester, because from then on, your baby starts to grow much faster.
Yes, and then in your third trimester, you're going to need a bit more, so about 450 to 500 calories per day. And by the way, if you're pregnant with multiples, the American College of Obstetricians and Gynecologists recommends about 300 calories per day and per baby.
That said, it is one thing to make sure that you get enough calories per day, right? Even more important is the question, what do you eat?
Right.
Because obviously, chocolate and junk food can also provide those extra calories, right? However, they don't provide your baby with the micronutrients that your baby so urgently needs.
Right. So let us walk you through our list of the 9 most important micronutrients that your baby needs. Calcium is one of the most important micronutrients for the baby because it helps build their bone structure as well as their teeth.
Mm-hmm.
On top of that, calcium also plays a role in the normal functioning of the circulatory, muscular and nervous system.
Yes, luckily it's normally not particularly difficult to provide your baby with calcium.
Mm-hmm.
It's contained in foods like broccoli, spinach, almonds, sardines, mineral water, as well as fortified foods and drinks such as cereals and juices. On top of that, it is also contained in dairy products like cheese and yogurt. Just make sure that whatever dairy product you eat during your pregnancy is fully pasteurized,
right?
By the way, you can find more such tips, as well as an even bigger list of foods containing calcium in the description below this video. Pollen plays an important role in the fetal brain development.
Yeah.
On top of that, it can also help reduce the risk of some common birth defects,
right?
Exactly.
Now, basically, your body is able to produce some pollen on its own, but it can normally not produce enough to meet the demand when you're pregnant.
Mm-hmm.
Therefore, it is important to get enough pollen from your diet. It can be found in products like peanuts, soy products, milk, eggs, but also chicken and beef.
Yes, just be careful if you suffer from food intolerances, right? And by the way, if you want to know the exact amount of pollen recommended, check out the description below this video. Mm-hmm.
During your pregnancy, your body's demand for iron almost doubles. That's because iron is used by your body to produce the extra blood that you and your baby need during pregnancy.
Yeah.
Also, if your body does not get enough iron, it can increase the risk of pregnancy-related complications, such as premature birth or a low birth weight, for instance.
Yes. Therefore, the American College of Obstetricians and Gynecologists recommends 27 milligrams of iron per day for pregnant women.
Mm-hmm.
Foods which contain iron include meat, shrimp, spinach, lentils and beans. And please keep in mind that iron from animal products can more easily be absorbed in the human body.
Yes, however, if you get most of your iron from supplements or plant-based products, then you have to make sure that you combine them with foods or drinks which contain vitamin C, because your body needs vitamin C in order to be able to properly absorb the iron from those foods. Yeah. Examples of foods containing vitamin C are broccoli, peppers, grapefruit, orange juice, or strawberries. Vitamin A is a bit tricky.
Yeah.
On the one hand, it is very important because it fulfills many important functions. For example, in terms of the development of the lungs, bones and teeth, but also skin and vision. On top of that, too little vitamin A can increase the risk of preterm birth and an underdeveloped baby.
Yes, on the other hand, getting too much vitamin A during the first few weeks of a pregnancy can lead to a higher incidence of birth defects.
Yeah.
Therefore, it is normally best to just cover the demand for vitamin A through a diet instead of going for vitamin A supplements. Right. You can find vitamin A in foods like pumpkin, carrots, apricots or spinach.
Yes, but if you intend to take supplements instead, it is best to double check with your provider first if you need the additional amount and also when is the best time to take them. You can find more information about vitamin A and the recommended amount in the description below this video.
Omega-3 fatty acids are just another super important nutrient for your baby because your baby urgently needs them for the development of baby's brain and vision.
Right.
Therefore, the American College of Obstetricians and Gynecologists recommends at least 2 servings of fish or shellfish per week before getting and while pregnant.
Right. That said, unfortunately, it cannot be any fish.
Yeah.
The best would be salmon, sardines and herring. But some types of fish contain higher levels of mercury than others, which is linked to birth defects. Examples are king mackerel, swordfish, and big eye tuna.
B vitamins in general play a very important role in the development of your baby.
Yeah.
For example, it was found that a deficiency of vitamin B12 during your pregnancy can lead to metabolic disorders such as diabetes type 2 later in your baby's life. Because of that, it is very important to make sure that your baby receives enough B vitamins.
Right. B vitamins are contained in chicken, cow's milk, yogurt, bananas, beans, bread and cereals. But you can find an even bigger list of foods containing B vitamins in the description below this video.
Okay, so those were the 6 most important micronutrients that you can normally absorb from your diet.
Right.
And now let's talk about 3 additional micronutrients that are probably even more important, but which you can normally not cover through your diet. Vitamin D has several functions. Mm-hmm. It helps with the metabolism in the body, nerve conduction and general cellular function.
Right.
It also plays a role in building the baby's bone structure and teeth together with calcium. And according to scientific studies, vitamin D also seems to be able to prevent pregnancy-related complications such as preeclampsia, gestational diabetes and other problems.
Right. Good sources of vitamin D are breakfast cereals, mushrooms, egg yolk, as well as fatty fish like salmon or Pacific mackerel. Just make sure you don't eat any king mackerel. However, please note that it is not always that simple to get enough vitamin D through your diet.
Yeah.
So another great source of vitamin D would be the sun. But that would obviously require you to be exposed to the sun, right?
Yeah, that's not always that easy, particularly if you live here in the UK, right? And because of that, it could make sense to take supplements.
Right.
However, it would be best to let your provider determine first if you do need any supplements.
Folate or folic acid, which is just a synthetic form of folate, are B vitamins too, which help form blood cells.
Yeah.
Most importantly though, folate is essential for your baby's growth as well as the normal development of your baby's brain and spine.
Yes, what's also good to know is that folate is particularly important in early pregnancy in order to reduce the risk of certain birth defects. Mm-hmm. In fact, many doctors recommend increasing the folate intake even several months before before conceiving. Right. The only thing they don't tell you is, how the hell should you know when exactly you are conceiving, right?
Yeah, that's gonna be difficult.
Very difficult.
Anyways, you will find folate in dried beans and peas, citrus fruits, as well as fortified cereals. However, it is very difficult to cover your body's demand of folate through your diet while you're pregnant.
Yeah.
And because of that, the American College of Obstetricians and Gynecologists recommends covering your folate demand through supplements.
Yes. If you want to know the exact amount that is being recommended, please check out the description below this video.
Right. Too much salt is never a good idea, no matter if you're pregnant or not, right?
Yeah.
However, it is important to note that table salt is often supplemented with iodine and thus an important source of iodine.
Mm-hmm.
And iodine is essential for your baby's brain development as well as the normal functioning of the thyroid.
Yes, and because of that, the National Institute of Health recommends 220 micrograms of iodine per day during your pregnancy, mm-hmm. right? Foods which contain iodine include iodized table salt, as already mentioned, but also Greek yogurt, cod, and shrimp. However, as the American College of Obstetricians and Gynecologists point out, if you consume salt mostly from eating ready-made foods, then it could make sense taking an iodine supplement of 150 micrograms a day during your pregnancy.
Right. Just be careful with iodine supplements when you suffer from thyroid-related problems, yeah. because it could make those problems worse.
Mm-hmm.
That said, in general, we always recommend not just buying any supplements.
Yeah.
You should always have your provider determine which micronutrients your body most urgently needs.
Yes. And finally, please make sure that you never take more than the recommended amount of vitamins
yeah.
per day, right? Keep in mind that some vitamins, like vitamin A, mm-hmm. can also have adverse effects on the baby if you take more than is needed, particularly for a longer period of time.
Right.
You can find more information about the recommended amount of micronutrients in the description below this video.
We really hope that you found this video helpful. If you did, we would be super grateful if you could leave us a like or even a comment in the comment section below.
Yes, and for more useful tips and tools on pregnancy and baby-related topics, make sure to subscribe to our channel and to hit the bell.